This movie is so violent. It takes pornography and mixes it with violence, and that's what you're supporting. And I'm talking about Christian women that are actually saying this out loud. Oh, it helped my marriage. And you know who you are, and I say this in love. You better check yourself before you wreck yourself.
It's Channel Mom with Jenny Dean Schmidt. We're here for you.
Yeah. I want to talk to the Christians that are listening.
Okay.
Because you know who you are. And you are the ones that are at the airport bookstore, and you picked up 50 Shades of Grey when you thought nobody was looking because you were traveling.
Yeah.
And you snuck it home, and you've been reading it, and you're secretly going to go out and see that excuse for a movie. And I think that I want to talk to the Christians that are actually considering going to see this, and you may not tell anybody, because let me tell you what matters. What matters is your dollars.
Yeah.
You put dollars toward a violent, sexualized rape of a movie, and you know what Hollywood's going to say? Christians, they have no power. Christians are going to complain about it on all of our blogs and all of our radio shows, but if you go and you buy a ticket for that movie, it's like what my grandma used to say, Jesus is always watching, okay?
Yeah.
But I am so passionate about this because we are lukewarm about our faith. We complain, we complain, we complain, and we go home, we turn on HBO. This movie is so violent. It takes pornography and mixes it with violence. And that's what you're supporting. And you may think it's, and I'm talking about Christian women that are actually saying this out loud. Oh, it helped my marriage. Oh, this book helped my marriage. I heard it, and you know who you are, and I say this in love. You better check yourself before you wreck yourself,
mm-hmm.
Okay? That's what my mother used to tell me. And the other thing I want to say to the people is if you think you're going to see this movie, would you take your daughter with you? And here's the thing. The lead girl in the movie, she won't let her mom, Melanie Griffith, by the way, see it. So what does that tell you? And people are all up in arms saying, I'm being judgy. Well, Jesus was judgy when he walked into the temple and he turned over the tables. And if let me tell you something, Jesus would not be at that movie. I'm so mad about it. And I'm telling you, I'm like, I'm going to be out there picketing. And I've gotten so much heat. I don't get political on my Facebook, but I've been on it with this movie. And people are like, you're being judgy. You're being a typical Christian. And I'm like, you know what? Call me a typical Christian. But when God comes back, he's going to be like, you know what? Did you stand up for my name?
And let me tell you something. Here's a line for you. Jesus would not be at that movie. He would just be loving the people who attend the movie. And so people take your judgment and think, you're saying Jesus, you know, doesn't love us because we partake in this movie. But the point is, he doesn't want to support that material. He'll love you anyway. So you're
and
not-
the other thing is, I used to do comedy in West Hollywood at a gay bar. And my friends were like, what are you doing there? I'm like, look, first of all, I'm not on the bar. I'm just doing comedy there. And they would say to me, it was a German bar. And they'd be like, Carrie, you're the first Christian that's ever been nice to me.
Yeah.
I went to church and they kicked me out. And I said, Jesus would be right there with me. Jesus would not wait outside.
No.
And I'm talking about secular people that don't know any better and they go see that movie.
Yes.
I can almost handle you guys. But it's the ones that do know better.
Yeah.
It's the ones that are going to watch that movie on a Saturday night and show up at church on Sunday morning. That is what I'm going to call out because we have power.
Yeah.
We have a voice. And if we publicly and privately, we walk the walk and talk the talk, we can make a difference and this movie can flop. And you know who's got the power? Moms. Moms
yes,
have
they do.
The power. I'm talking about sending an email, doing whatever you can from the privacy of your most. But the most important power you have is not putting money into it because that's all they care about.
All right. That was Carrie's soapbox. She'll get back
that
down off
my,
of it
not
now.
Not so funny commentary. Don't get me mad. Don't get an Italian mama mad like I'm just telling you.